Hi, you guys. Good morning. I hope you are having a great Thursday so far. I know it's gloomy. I know it's overcast. I know things are crazy right now with this fire, and it's just a lot going on, as y'all know. But focusing on the good, focusing on the positive, amen. And speaking of focusing on the positive, for this Candace Carr confession, it just has really, really been on my spirit and my heart to just want to celebrate all of the survivors out there. I mean, you have survived assault, you have survived a broken home, you have survived starvation, you have survived a broken heart, you have survived debt, you have survived college, you have survived everything. Like, I know I am definitely someone that really struggles with celebrating my successes or celebrating my accomplishments or my wins, because I'm always, always focused on the end goal. Like, I am nowhere where I know that God has called me to be. And because of that, like, I bypass all these great things that I've accomplished, all these great things that I have overcome, all these great things that God has brought me through. Amen. Because I'm just so focused on the end goal. Like, that's where I need to go. So all this other stuff, I'm not enjoying the process, or I'm not celebrating along the journey. Does that make sense? And my friends tell me that all the time. Like, Candace, it's okay to relax. It's okay to, like, you've accomplished a lot. It's okay, you know, but it's hard for me because, like I said, I'm not where I want to be, and I'm not where I know God is ultimately calling me to, right? In terms of that greatness. But y'all, we have made it. Like, we have made it. Life has been hard. You feel me? Like, hard, hard, hard. And you could have given up. I could have given up at any point in time, because the enemy is always there. The enemy is always trying to trick your mind. He's always trying to feed your spirit negative thoughts and negative things. No one loves me. No one cares. No one would care if I died, if I wasn't here anymore. Oh, it'll never happen. I might as well just give up now. Like, y'all, I'm about to come up on my 10th year anniversary of living in Los Angeles. My anniversary is next month. 10 years. Do you know how many people come to Los Angeles with a dream? I literally moved out here with only $600 to my name and whatever I could fit in my Toyota Avalon. And I came out here, and it has not been easy. Yes, Jesus. But I never went back home. Like, I never quit. Like, I never decided to say, I'm going to just do that 9-to-5, or I'm going to just, you know, this is too. When you know what you are called to do, nothing will deter you, no matter how much life throws at you, no matter what happens. That's why I always say, I can have a moment, I can vent, I can cry, I can, you know, I can have, be human. But the thing is, I will never quit, because I know what the purpose is, what I'm called to do, and what my end looks like. Amen. So for everyone who has never quit, like, you did not quit, even the days that you didn't want to, even the days where you're like, I can't read my word today, I can't talk to you today, God, me and you, we having issues right now, Father God, like, I don't want to get out of bed, but you still did. You still got up. You still chose to love again after your heart was destroyed and broken by that person. You still chose to trust again after your trust and possibly even your body was violated. Like, you decided to leap out on faith after being backstabbed. Like, you did not give up. You are amazing. Do you hear me? You are amazing. So I don't care what anybody says about you or to you. I don't care what any of the thoughts and the negativity that the enemy is trying to put into your spirit. Rebuke that in the name of Jesus, because guess what? You are still here standing. And because you're still here, you still got work to do. Amen. But I really just want to celebrate you. And I just want to, you are so strong. Like, the strength of a survivor, man. Like, and now all of these seasons, all of these years of just surviving, we are now about to walk into that season of thriving. Amen. Yes, Jesus, I am declaring it and I am believing it, that no longer will I just be on this earth just to survive, but on this earth to thrive, on this earth to have abundance, on this earth to have so much peace and overflow in the name of Jesus. Like, it will happen. Like, it will happen. You know? So I just wanted to celebrate y'all today and just be like, be proud of yourself. Don't be hard on yourself. You made it. You still here. And that is a blessing. I love y'all.